Let's see how we can find an explicit formula for a given sequence, and we'll do a total of 8 sequences. Right here for the first one, 18, 11, 4, negative 3, negative 10, and so on, so on, so on. Well, as we can see from here to here, it's just minus 7, and then 11 minus 7 does give us 4, and this pattern does continue. So right here, we know we have an arithmetic sequence. The common difference is just negative 7. And we have the general form for an arithmetic sequence. An equals the first term plus n minus 1 times the common difference. A1 is the first term, which is 18. And then we add n minus 1 times d, which is negative 7. That's pretty much it. But usually, we like to clean this up. So this times this, this times that. We get 18 minus 7n plus 7. So finally, we see that's negative 7n. And then this and that is plus 25. So an is negative 7n plus 25. All right, number 2. We have 3 over 4, 4 over 7, 5 over 10, 6 over 13, 7 over 16. As we can see, the top is just going up by 1, and the bottom is just going up by 3. However, do not just say 3 over 4 plus 1 over 3 is equal to 4 over 7. This is unfortunately not how we add fractions. So the way to do it is we are going to separate the numerators and the denominators. For the top, we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. As we can see though, each time is just adding 1. Therefore, it's arithmetic. We can say, let me just say tn for the top sequence. That will be the first term, which is 3, plus n minus 1 times the common difference, which is 1. So this means 3 plus n minus 1, so we get n plus 2. Now, for the bottom, we have 4, 7, 10, 13, 16, and so on. Each time, we add 3. And here, let me show you guys a fast way to do this. For the bottom sequence, I can actually write down the formula for you guys. The common difference is actually going to be the coefficient of n. You see, like the common difference times n is that, right? So we will have 3n for sure. That is guaranteed. And now, this is the case when n is equal to 1, right? If you put 1 in here, 3 times 1 is 3. How much more do we need in order to get to 4? The answer is plus 1 more. So the answer for that is just plus 1, and that's bn. And of course, you can still use this right here. The first term is 4, and then plus n minus 1 times the common difference. Work this out, 4 plus 3n minus 3, and of course, you end up with this as well. So, top and also the bottom, finally though, our an, I will put this down right here, it's equal to the top over bottom. So it's n plus 2 over 3n plus 1. Now for number 3, we have 4, negative 1, 1 over 4, negative 1 over 16, 1 over 64, and so on, so on, so on. And yes, each every time we're just dividing by negative 4. But you need to look at this as multiplying by negative 1 over 4. Because this is the common ratio. And we will know that this right here is a geometric sequence with r equals negative 1 over 4. And we have a general formula for that as well. An equals the first term times the common ratio and then raised to the n minus 1 power. And now we can just go ahead and plug in the values. A1 is 4 times r is negative 1 over 4 and then raised to the n minus 1 power. And that's pretty much it. This is totally okay. All right, number 4, we have 1 over 2, negative 4 over 3, 9 over 4, negative 16 over 5, 25 over 6, and so on. Well, for this one in particular, let me help you guys out by labeling this as A1. Let's just put it down, it helps. And the next term is of course A2, and then A3, and then A4, and then A5. And our goal is, look at this subscripts and try to go from here to here. So if you do this, then you'll see that AN is going to be the following. For the bottom, it's just 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Well, if you look at the 5, that's just one more than the index. And this is meant to be N. So the bottom is just one more than that, and that is N plus 1. And true for this one here, right here, right? 5 plus 1 is 6. Now, how can we get to 25 though? We know 5 squared is equal to 25. 3 squared is 9. 4 squared, that's negative 16. But don't worry, we must have N squared, yeah, to produce the perfect square numbers on the top. But we have positive, negative, positive, negative, and so on. In this case, we are just going to multiply by the factor negative 1 raised to the n minus 1 power. Remember, this factor will help you to alternate the sign, right? If you have the power n minus 1 here, then this will start with positive. You can also check, when n is 1, put it here, you get 0's power. Negative 1 to a 0's power is positive 1. When n is 4, put it here. 4 minus 1 is 3, negative 1 to a 3rd power is negative 1. And then 4 squared, and then 5. Done. Now, number 5. This right here, it's a little bit trickier. 1, 0, negative 1, 0, 1, 0, negative 1, 0, and so on, so on, so on. This is not alternating between 1 and 0 because we have negative 1 as well. So how can we do it? Well, notice this is a repeating sequence. So the best bet is to rely on trig functions, either sine or cosine. And because we're just looking at 1, 0, negative 1, let's take a look at the unit circle. And let's look at the important points. Let's say here, 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 and here. And the reason why is because the x value and the y value here is 1, 0. You only get 1s and 0s on these 4 points. Now, because we're starting with 1, so let's focus on the cosine value, which is the x component on the unit circle. Have a look. This is 1, and then once we rotate 90 degrees, or you know, rotate pi over 2 radians, we get to 0, 1. And then once we do it again, this right here is negative 1, 0, focusing on the cosine value. And lastly, right here, this is 0, negative 1. Again, focus on the cosine value. So in fact, we can just use cosine to help ourselves with this. An equals cosine, and we want to start with this right here. And each every time, we are adding pi over 2. So inside of the cosine function, it's a what? It's an arithmetic sequence. So right here, I'm going to start off with the 0 radian. So that's my first term. All right. And then after that, I'm going to add it with n minus 1 times the common difference, which is pi over 2. Again, this part inside is the arithmetic sequence starting from here and then go up by pi over 2 every time. 0 radian and then pi over 2 radian every time for the common difference. Right now, we can just go ahead and simplify this. An will be cosine of, I think it's actually a good idea to just leave it like that. I will write it as n minus 1 times pi over 2. And that will do it. And you can also double check. When n is 1, put it here, that will be cosine 0, which is 1. When n is 2, put it here, you get pi over 2, which is right here. Right? And remember, this is A1, n starts with 1. So this works. All right, Number 6, negative 1 half, 1 over 6, negative 1 over 24, 1 over 120, negative 1 over 720. As we can see, the top right here start with negative 1 and then it alternates, right? Negative 1, 1, negative 1, 1, and so on. So we can actually write this down right away. We must have a what? Negative 1 raised to the nth power. Because again, n start with 1. So this right here is a1. Now for the bottom. It's plus 4 plus 18 plus a lot of number. I don't think it's adding. How about let's look at this as what? Multiply by 3. Yeah? But 3 times 6 is 18. However, we know 4 times 6 is 24. Well, they are not the same number though, so this is not geometric. But I think we have a pattern for these numbers, huh? Because what times 24 is equal to 120? 5, right? 5 times that is that. So we multiply by 3, 4, 5, and the next one is we multiply by 6, and so on, so on, so on. Cool. So whenever these kind of things happen, what do we get? This is an example of the factorial. So if you just look at the bottom, this 6, it's the same as 3 factorial. This 120, it's the same as 5 factorial. In another word, we just go from 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Multiply them and we get the factorial. But be careful though, this is a4. Do not put down n factorial. The 120 here, right? 120 here, it's actually 5 factorial, right? Because that is start with 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, yeah? So if we have subscript n for the inside, we will have to add 1 to it. And then you do the factorial. So the formula for this is negative 1 to the nth power over n plus 1 factorial. Just like this. Number 7, we have 3, 8, 15, 24, 35, and so on. What can we do though? It seems like if we go from 3 to 8 is by adding 5. And if we go from 8 to 15, okay, we can say that's plus 7. And then just keep going, right? Unfortunately, though, these numbers are not the same. So this right here is not an arithmetic sequence. However, can we predict what's in the next term that we have to add? Yes, we have to add 13, right? There is a pattern with these numbers. It's just that every time we will have to add 2. This right here is what we call the first difference. This right here is what we call the second difference. When we have the second difference being a constant, we know the sequence is a quadratic sequence. So you can start off by saying an is equal to a quadratic sequence, an squared plus bn plus c. And then just plug in values to figure out the A, B, C. But I'm going to leave this to you. I will have a video in the description showing you guys how to do this way. But for this one in particular, let me show you guys a better way. Here we go. First term is of course A1. Second term, A2. And then A3, A4, A5. Remember, our goal is always to go from the index to the result. So that's how we can write an. Now, let's think about it. How can we go from 1 to 3, 2 to 8, 3 to 15, 4 to 24? Hey, 4 times 6 is equal to 24. And then 5 times 7 is 35. So right here, it looks like this is just 1 times 3. This right here is just 2 times 4. And this right here is just 3 times 5, and then 4 times 6, and this right here is 5 times 7, and so on, so on, so on. So, if we have an n right here, all we have to do is, we have the n right here again, and multiply by 2 more than the n value. So, this right here will be n plus 2. And in fact, if you multiply, you get n squared plus 2n, which is, of course, a quadratic. All right, last one. 1 half, 4 over 5, 9 over 10, 16 over 17, 25 over 26. 1 and 2, 4 and 5, 9 and 10, 16 and 17. The bottom is just one more than the numerator. That's all. So here, let me write this down for you. The top, you see, is just 5 and you square that. So we have n squared on the top. And then the bottom is just one more than the top. So it's just n squared plus 1. Done.